Welcome to this video lecture on simulation and modeling using SimU software. So in this video lecture, first of all, I will try to introduce the basics of SimU software, and then we are going to solve a ice cream store problem using a SimU software. So in order to open the SimU software, so what we are going to do is, so we can go to our start menu, and from the SimU folder, so we can open this SimU software. So right now I am using the SimU 14th version, which is an academic version basically. So you can also download your personal software as well from the SimU website. So once we open it, it will be look like this one. So over here you can see there are multiple tabs, such as project home tab, run tab, drawing, okay, animation, and so on. So in a sport tab, okay, so if we click over SimU homepage, it will take us on the SimU website, which is simu.com. so from the product you can see that simulation software, so you can download your personal software from here, okay. So that is basically their website, okay. So in a sport tab, basically you can also check sample SimBit solutions. So what this tab do is, it will give us some help, like if you want to take some help on a particular object of a SimU, so you can search from here and you will get the help. So such as if I want to know about the electric vehicle object, if I want to know about find a minimum state value, what does this means, okay. Similarly, notify steps, so you can click and it will give you an example from the SimU software. Similarly, you can also check already built-in examples which are available, okay. So in order to see how the SimU works, okay, as well as you can take the help of those examples in order to build another model. So we have also books, videos, trainings, okay, and so on. So these are the different basically help regarding to learn the SimU. Okay, so if we back to the project home page or the run tab, okay, so let me introduce about this particular window. Like this window is indicating what. So in this window we can see that we have different tabs, okay, like as I have already told you earlier, which is project home, run, drawing. So over here in the bottom side we can see that so whenever we have opening a SimU software, there is a default project which is my SimU project name, okay. In this SimU project we have two objects, one is a model entity, another is model, okay. Basically the model is indicating the flow of your process, or you can say the design of your system. So okay, like how your process or the system is behaving, okay. Whereas the model entity is the object which is moving into that model or into that system, okay. So first of all, what we can do it, you can change the name of this particular project, okay, by right clicking on my SimU project, by clicking on the rename, so you can rename it. Similarly, you can also rename the model entity, okay, by right clicking over here. You can also check every object's property. How you can do that? We can click on the model entity, right click. If I click over the property, so you will get a property window, okay. So that is indicating properties of the model entity. So in the SimU we are going to use the multiple type of objects, and every object have some properties which are very important, because we are going to change the property. So basically properties are indicating how that object is behaving, or you can say how the model entity is going to behave when it is passing through that particular object, okay. So similarly we have the model property. If I right click over here, so this there, if I click over here, so you can see this is the model property. We have some general options, we have some advanced options, and so on. So on the bottom side over here, we have the project library that is basically indicating these two objects. One is model and another is model entity. And furthermore, we have some libraries. We have standard libraries, flow libraries, and extra libraries. So in these libraries, we have the multiple types of objects which we are going to use in order to develop any system model, or you can say the process model. Okay. So this is basically a brief overview regarding the SIMU software. So one more thing, when we are going to run any model, okay, or we are going to build the SIMU model, and then we are going to perform some experiment, or we are going to run that SIMU model. So make sure in the run tab, we have specified the unit setting as per our own requirement, because SIMU is going to use some default settings, like it will take always time in hours. So if you want to make it minutes, seconds, days, or weeks, so it's up to you. Similarly for length and distance, similarly for area, volume, mass, and weight. Okay, so basically the unit setting is important when we are running the model, and we will get the answer on those units which we have set over here. Okay. So in order to perform the simulation model in a SIMU, so let's take example of ice cream store. And what's the problem is, so they are saying there is a small ice cream store. So in that store, customer arrives and wait in a line served by one of the two attendees. Okay, so here we have draw a process flow diagram, or you can say the flow chart. Okay, how the customer arrive and what is going to do, okay, and next, and then what is going to do next, and so on. Okay, so the first of all, customer arrive, and we have collected the data that how the customer arriving into the system, or okay, or how the customer is entering into the system. So we are saying customer enter into the ice cream store with the help of the probability distribution of exponentially distributed, that is 0.5 minutes. Okay. So that means after every half minute, there is a customer arrival into the store, and the travel time from arrival into the store and to move to the server, okay, which is giving the ice cream, okay, that is basically the 15 seconds. Okay, so the customer arrive at the rate of exponentially distributed. So basically, and the distribution of the customer arrival is exponential distribution, and the inter arrival time, that is basically the 0.5 minutes. So after every half a minute, so there is a customer enter into the system. Okay, then the travel time from enter into the system to go to the attendees to get the ice cream, that is 15 seconds. And then order ice cream, that is basically we have the two attendees over there. And the service time is basically the triangularly distributed. Then the travel time after getting the service from the one of the attendee, so there is again 15 seconds. And then they are paying, the customer is paying to the cashier, okay, and then 15 seconds to leave the store. So that is basically the whole process flow diagram is in order to enter into the store, and after getting the services, leaving the store. So this is the information which we have already mentioned in this particular flow diagram, that is also mentioned over there. So now we want to analyze this basically problem, or you can say the ice cream store problem. So how we can do that? So for that, first of all, we are going to use different SIMU objects. Okay. So in order to show that the customer, the store is, the customer is entered into the store, so we are going to use object called source. Okay, so we will just click over here and drag and drop the source object. Okay, and then after that, what we are going to do is, actually I have just created two sources, so let me again click and drag and drop. Okay, so this is source one. So here we are saying the customer, basically we are indicating the customer enter into the store. Okay, And then we are saying there is another object which is server, again drag and drop. And this server is basically acting as the ice cream delivery guy. Okay, so we will mention that here we have basically a workstation for the two attendees who are providing the ice cream to the customer. And then there is another server that is basically for the cashier. And then after that, we are going to use a sync object, which is basically acting as that the customer is leaving the system. Okay, so this is basically a flow diagram, or you can say the flow chart of the entire process. So for that, we are going to use these main three objects. One is source, another is sync, another is server. As I told you earlier, that every object in a CMU has some properties, right? Like this source has some properties over here. This server has some properties over here. Similarly, sync node, they have some properties over here. So either you can say sync node, server node, or source node, or either we can say server object or a source object or a server object or a sync object. Okay. Now, in order to show the model entity, which means basically in this ice cream store problem, what is the model entity, or you can say the flow unit, which is basically the customer. So how we can show that the customer are entering into the system, or in order to show the customer for the model, we are going to use model entity, and we will again drag and drop this model entity. Now what I am going to do is I am giving the name to every object. So this is basically the customer. So I can write down customer over here. Okay, so this basically diagram is indicating that is a customer. Here we are indicating the source node. So SRC is a source, and I am saying this source node is indicating the customer arrival. Okay, into the system. Okay, and then after entering into the system, it goes towards the server. So what is the server? That is basically SRV is basically representing server of the ice cream. Okay, and then we are giving the name. This is basically a server, but it's a cashier. Okay, it's a cashier, right? And lastly, we can say that customer leaves. This is basically a sync node. So we can say SNK customer leaves. Okay, leave the system. Now, in order to draw a proper process flow diagram, right now we just mentioned the object. So how the customer enter into the system and what would be the flow? So in order to mention the flow, we need another object which is called as time path. Why I am using the time path? Because they are indicating over here that the data we have collected, or we are going to model it, that customer when it is moving in the store from entering into the system to get the ice cream, it is 15 seconds. But if we mention this one in a distance perspective, then we can use another object instead of the time path. We can use path. Okay. So I will also talk about in detail later what's the difference between path, time path. Even we can also use connector. So what are the difference? We will discuss in a minute. But let me use the time path first. So we can connecting the source with the server one, which is time path one. Again, I am clicking on the object and then click over here and then connect to the server two, time path over here, and this is. So this is the entire process flow diagram. So right now we haven't mentioned the properties of every object. Like we haven't mentioned that the time path is basically the travel time is 15 seconds. So we haven't mentioned. So similarly, we haven't mentioned what's the arrival pattern of the customer into the system. So we'll discuss later, but first of all, let me talk about that we are seeing different things on our model. So what we are going we are seeing the things in our model, which is basically you are seeing that when we have clicked the source object, and in a source object we have this blue diamond sign. Similarly, in a server node we have this gray diamond, and this is basically a blue diamond sign. Similarly, this is gray. So technically what we are calling it, this is called as basic node, or you can say over here it's an input node, this is output node, or as well as a transfer node. So from the standard library you can also check basic node and the transfer node. Okay, so right now you just consider them as an input and output node. Literally in the coming videos we will discuss these nodes as well, what's the difference between them and what is the advantage of using the basic node and what's the advantage of using the transfer node, and under what condition we are going to use basic and the transfer. But right now the only usage in the server object of this basic node is to get the input from the previous node, and this is basically the transfer node is giving us the output from this server. Okay, and then we have seen these different green lines. Okay, like such as every server has three lines. One is input buffer. Okay, then we have the process buffer, or you can say process content in terms of CMU language. This is output buffer. So what the output buffer is indicating, so basically over here we are saying that it is used to store the entities waiting to move out of the object. So whenever we are seeing some entity over here, that is indicating, so this is the output buffer line, or we can say the waiting line of the model entity or the customer that it want to move further. Okay, so they are waiting over here. Similarly, input buffer is indicating they want to enter into that service to get the services. Okay, similarly processing content is indicating that the a particular model entity right now in a service. Okay, similarly for the cashier, okay, this is only the input, this is only when the customer arrival is the output buffer we have. Okay, so now we want to enter the properties of every particular object. Okay, first of all, as we have given the name of the source, so how we can do that, as we have already given the name, so there is a two way to write down the name. Either we can simply double click over here, or either I can click on that particular object. In the property section, go to the general tab, write down the name, whatever you want. Okay, so there is a these two way we can use to write down the name. Okay, or we can simply right click on the object, you can click on the rename in order to give the name of that particular object. Okay, so now we want to add the you can say data related to the particular flow. So what kind of data we are going to enter is that is how the customer arrival. So we are saying the source node, at a source node the customer entered into the store exponentially distributed with the time is 0.5 minutes. So we will click on a source node, and the model entity enter into this system is the customer, that is the name of the model entity. Okay, and then we are going to click on basically the inter arrival time, right? That is basically the inter arrival time, and over here they are mentioning, we have to mention that the customer is entering into the system exponentially distributed. So for that we need to use a expression. Okay, so for that when we are going to click over this arrow in order to define that the customer arrival into the system is exponentially distributed, what I am going to do is I will write down random. Okay, dot. So once I press the button tab of dot, so you will see there are different type of probability distributions. So the probability distribution we are going to use, as we have already defined, which is exponential. So I will click over here, and what's the parameter value of the exponential distribution? That is 0.5 minutes. Okay, so once I've done this, I will click this yes button, and the unit is already in minutes. So if it was in seconds, so I will click on seconds, but right now it's minutes, so I will left as it is. Okay, now the time was the travel time they have given us, which is the 15 seconds. Okay, so I will click on time part one. Okay, and then I need to mention the travel time. So this is the travel time, so I will click over here. This is 15 seconds. So okay, so from the unit I am going to select the seconds, right? So this is 15 seconds. Similarly, on a server one, we have the two attendees. Okay, so once I click over here, so first of all, these two attendees means we have the initial capacity. Instead of only one server, we have the two servers. Okay, and then we need to mention the processing time. So the processing time is basically a triangular distribution. So I can write down random dot try. Okay, this is triangular, and minimum mod and maximum. So what's the minimum value? That is 0.4. what is the mod value? Which is 0.9. so I can write over here, which is 0.4, then we have 0.9, and the maximum is 0.1.5. okay, so here we can mention, so right click over here, and the unit was in minutes. Okay, it's in minutes. So we have mentioned the two attendees, and we have mentioned the time, and the unit is minutes. Similarly, now we need to mention the time of this travel time. This is also the 15 seconds. So click on the time path to mention the travel time, which is 15 seconds. So the seconds, we will click over here. And now we have to mention the service time of the cashier. Okay, this is only one cashier, so that's why we will left the initial capacity one. And the processing time is again a random triangular. Okay, and as they have given the default, so the time is 0.3, 0.4, and 0.6. So we will mention this time over here, 0.3. Okay, so I can write simply 0.3, 0.4, 0.6. So these are the three parameter values which we have to given. Okay, so once we have done this, this is in minutes. Again, we need to mention the travel time from path 3 to exit from the store. So the travel time is again 15. So the unit is not minutes, but the seconds. Okay, so now we have mentioned all the properties related to the model's objects. Okay, so we mentioned the travel time. Okay, we mentioned the cashier service time, again the travel time from path 2, service time at this end, this one, and this one. So now we can run this model. But as I told you earlier, that before running the model, so you have to make sure that in a unit setting, how you want to see the results, whether you want to see the result in hours or minutes. So let's say we want to see the results instead of hours, we want to see in minutes. Okay, so let me run this model. Okay, but one more thing which is very important. As you can see from the run, it is indicating when this simulation model is going to run and when it is going to end. Okay, so we have to specify whether you want to specify the time over here, like whether you want to run this for 2 hour simulation model, for 3 hour or 5 hour or 8 hour or 1 day, whatever you want. Or you can either specify that it should be run this infinite time, or you can specify that it should run for 8 hours. Okay, like we can only analyze this system for 8 hour shift or a 1 day. Okay, so let me specify this one and then now click on run tab. So as you can see that as soon as I have clicked on the run tab, so we can see that that the model entity enter into the system, it goes to the first server, then it moves to the second server and exiting to the system. So this is basically a 2D model, okay, a two-dimensional model. So if I go over view and if I click over 3D, we can see this 3D. If I press the right click and you can say move the mouse, so you can see on the different dimensions of this particular model. Okay, similarly we can click over 2D, okay, and we can adjust with the help of zoom in zoom out with the mouse. Okay, so now let me again go to the run tab. If I click over fast forward, okay, what it will do, it will complete the simulation for 8 hours, okay, and at the end, after we are getting 100% end of run, so if you click over result tab, we will see different kinds of results. So in our model, we have different type of objects. We have the model entity, we have a server, and we have two types of server. One is cashier and other is basically who served the ice cream. And then we have the sync node. Okay, we have the source object, we have time path object, and these are the three types of time path object. This is time path 1 between source to server 1, this is from server 1 to server 2, this is between server 3 to sync. Okay, and we are getting different types of data. That is basically we are getting the information regarding the content, which is basically indicating the number in system. Okay, so against the model entity, the number in system is indicating how many customers right now on average in the system available. Okay, so similarly we have a time in system, that is again we can see that the answer is in minutes. Okay, similarly we are getting the throughput. Okay, that is basically the number created for the system and how many entities destroy, or you can say they are not ending into the system. Okay, similarly we are getting some capacity related results. So let me discuss these results in a bit detail, but before discussing the results, as I told you earlier that let me click over here model and the facility. So we have basically connected the source node with the server with the time path, okay, from the time path object instead of path and the connector. So under what condition we are going to use basically the connector, and under what condition we are going to use time path, and under what condition we can use path. If the transfer time, you are saying that from one server to another server or from source to as the server. So basically between two objects, if the transfer time is zero, so we can use connector. Okay. If the transfer is basically you are measuring with respect to time as well as there is a travel capacity, as well as you can also mention that the travel is basically a unidirectional or a bidirectional. That means that is it is moving only from source 1 to object server 1, or either it's a bidirectional, it can move from source to server and server to source, so then it would be a bidirectional. So right now in our case it's a unidirectional, okay, and we have considered that the travel capacity is infinity. Okay, so we consider that one, that as many customers arrive we can deal with them. Okay, and similarly we have mentioned the time in minutes. But if instead of the time we want to model it with respect to the distance perspective, so then we can use the path. So in over there, then we have to see that from source to server one, how much distance it is going to cover and what is the speed of the entity to travel from that object to another object. So in short, or in a simple sense, if you want to model it with respect to the distance perspective, use the path object. If you want to model it with respect to the time perspective, go to the time path. If there is no transfer time, go to the connector, okay, in order to connect multiple objects. Okay, so this thing we have already seen. The important thing over here is right now are the results, Okay, so as we have seen that once we are running, before that we have to mention the how long we want to simulate this particular project. So now as we have seen from the result tab, we have multiple type of objects. Okay, like we have mentioned that for the server, and we have the two types of server. One is server get ice cream resource and its capacity, and there are different types of information which we can get, such as schedule utilization against the server, what they are indicating, such as from the category for the statistics. So these are basically the categories. Okay, so the data item against that one is content, throughput, capacity, flow time, resource state, and holding time. And waiting at that service, basically that is a holding time of the input buffer is indicating. Okay, if there is a number in queue, that is basically in a CMU it will be written as content of the input buffer. So that is basically indicating how many model entity in the input buffer. So there are different type of utilization, such as scheduling utilization, which we are going to calculate CMU this way. Similarly, unit allocated, unit scheduled, unit utilized. Okay, so this is basically the actual time the resource is utilized divided by the total available capacity, how they are going to calculate the schedule utilization. Okay, okay, so now we can see that from the result tab that what's the scheduling utilization percentage, like how that is 87.05% this resource is currently using. Okay, how many units are allocated to that particular source, and so on. Similarly, how many model entities in any particular time available in the system, what's the minimum model entity in the system, what's the maximum model entity into the system. So there is a different way. Similarly, here we can see different types of filter. Like right now I do not want to see all the model entities results. I just want to see only the server objects results. So if I unclick all the options and only check the server and press OK, you can see over here server. And we have two types of server. One is server cashier and another is ice cream. So let's say again I want to filter this one, and I only want to check at a cashier level what's going on. Okay, let me click on the ice cream, that is the two attendees. Okay, so over here we can see the results, that is basically regarding the capacity, the resource state, input buffer mean, how many entities in the waiting, holding time, throughput time, output, and processing. Okay, so this is how we are getting some results. Now as you can see that we are only getting the average time in a response. Let's say we want to perform some experiment. Okay, how we can do that? Like we want to simulate it 10 times, because in a simulation repetition is very important. So for that we in order to perform the repetition of the experiments, so how we can do that? We will go in the project home. Here we have a new experiment. If I click over here, so you can see that this particular scenario, whatever the information we have put in the model, it will run 10 times. So you can increase the numbers, so whether we want to run this 100 times, or you want to run it 10 times, so whatever the number you want to do, so you can use it. So right now let me use this 10 times. So if I run over here, so right now it is running. So the 10 times this experiment is completed. Now if I click from the tab of this one, pivot grid. Okay, so in a pivot grid, now you can see that instead of only giving us the average results, it is also giving us the minimum, maximum, and half grid. So that is basically indicating that the minimum number of, after performing 10 experiment, the minimum number of on average customer in the system is this one. The maximum number of customer on average in the system is this one. And this is basically the half of the confidence interval. Okay, half it means that is basically the confidence intervals half value, which is 1.9311. Okay, so this experiment is very important. This experiment output in a project home, from this experiment, this is very important in order to perform some scenario analysis. So what the scenario analysis is, that is basically, let me show you, okay, like for example, if I am saying, so let me stop this one. If I am saying that right now the initial capacity of the server which we are using is 2. So what if the server capacity is increased to 3? So what would be the results? So what if I am using 4 server, what would be the result? So basically we are performing some scenario analysis in order to check how many server we should use in order to give the best service to the customers. Okay, right now we are analyzing only this particular server. So basically we are going to perform some scenario analysis. In order to do that, first of all, what we need to do is we are going to click in the server object. Okay, and then the next stage we need to do is from the initial capacity, okay, over here. So we will click the right on initial capacity, right click, and then we are going to click set references, and on the bottom side we are checking the value create new reference property. So if I click over here, so they are saying, what do you want to give the name of this one? So let me give the server ice cream capacity. Okay, I am removing the initial word, I am giving okay. So now if I move towards project home, okay, and then I am going to click the experiment. Okay, so from the experiment to which I am creating, as you can see that now here we have a output. So because that is basically the scenario one, so that we are going to model this scenario when the server is 2 and we want to see the results. Similarly, I want to add another scenario. So click over here, you can say double click, and we want to add another scenario that instead of in the model section, the server is 2, we want to say that the server is 3. Another scenario we want to add is, like instead of 3, let me check if there is 4, what would be the answer. So we have created 3 scenarios, and every scenario we are repeating 10 times. And now if I want to run this result, okay, so right now scenario 1 is running, scenario 2 is running, scenario 3 is also running. So all the scenario results are completed. If I click over here, that is the pivot grid. So right now it is giving us the answer according to the scenario 1 when we were using server 1, okay, when we were using server 2, and when we were using in a scenario 2 server 3, and when we were using server 4. So now you can compare the results with the help of, like for example, how many customer are in the system when there is server 2, when there is server 3, when there is server 4. Okay, so in order to check the best number of server we should allocate. Okay, now let me add one more thing, that is basically the response. Okay, like I want to add, or I want to analyze this system with respect to the time in a system of a model entity at different level of the system. So how can I do that? In a design tab, I can click from this, I can click add response. So from a response, first of all, I am giving the name because I want to find out the time in system. Okay, so that is the response name. And I want to specify, I mean, I want to calculate. What I want to calculate, that how long a customer is spending at server 1, server 2, server 3, mean at every section how long it is taking. Okay, so overall, basically it is indicating overall in a system how long it will take on average. So I am clicking customer, that is my model entity. Then I press dot from, then I will click population dot, right now whether I am interested in time in system, how many customer in the system, or number of customer destroyed from the system or created. So right now I am interested in time in system. Then again press dot whether you are interested in minimum value, maximum value, or average. So I am clicking average. So press yes. Okay. Now again we need to run the model. Okay. So let me again, after clicking on reset, let me run the model again. So right now it's running the model, and you can see that at against every scenario they are calculating the time in system. So basically this is average time in a system. So when the server was 2, so the average time in a system of every particular, a single particular customer is this one. Similarly when there is 3, when there is 4. So if I click on response result, and in a response result if I click over here and click on time in system, you can see that against scenario 1, scenario 2, scenario 3, when there is a 2 server, when there is 3 server, when there is a 4 server. So the average time in a system. Okay, so this plot is called as SMOR plot, SIMU. Okay, which is known as, let me show you this one. So this plot is basically a SMOR plot, which means SIMU Meyer of risk error plot. Okay, so this is Meyer of risk error, risk and error plot basically. And this is basically indicating the maximum value, this is indicating the minimum value, so this is basically indicating the upper percentile, this is indicating the lower percentile, this is median value, and this is indicating the mean confidence interval. Okay, similarly this is basically indicating the upper percentile confidence interval as well as lower percentile confidence interval. So right now as we can see that on average, okay, even if you take the cursor to that plot, it will show us the results. So we can see that the average time in a system that is best for us is the scenario 2, when we are using 3 server. So instead of 2 or instead of 4, so it would be better to use 3 server in order to make the time in a system for the customer is as less as possible, or you can say the lead time of the customer is as less as possible. I hope you got the idea like how we can formulate this particular problem in a SIMU and how we are going to analyze and interpret the result. So thank you so much. See you in the next video.